What's going on, everybody? I hope you all are well out there. So for those of you who don't know who I am Jaren, voice teacher, speech trainer, and the founder and owner of this here studio, the Jaren M. LeGray Studio. And in this video, we're going to finally get to a person who I've been meaning to get to forever. I don't know why it took me so long to get to him, but I've been wanting to talk about him. He has such a unique voice, and I know he's been requested quite a bit here on this channel. So let's get right into it, y'all. Here is GIVĒON singing Heartbreak Anniversary at Coachella.
Balloons are deflated, guess they look lifeless like me. We miss you on your side of the bed. Still got your things here, and they stare at me like souvenirs. Don't wanna let you out of my head.
So one thing I love about his voice is the uniqueness of his sound. There's almost a long, dark quality to his timbre, to his voice. And I love that he stays true to that very thing when he sings. He doesn't try to go too high, too low. He just really stays right within what's good for him and what feels good for him vocally. And it is clearly working for him, obviously. So that long quality is almost like that jaw. And maybe a little tongue, back of tongue action. And I don't sound like him in any way, shape, or form, but I think there's a little tongue back there going on as well, which makes that sound more rich. You know, using the back of your tongue to enhance your tone can make your tone, or your timbre, I'm sorry, a little more rich or fuller depending on what you're looking for, you know. And honestly, timbre and texture, the descriptives of them therein are really dependent upon our biases and what we like and what we describe things to be as, you know. So just the texture of his sound has a longer, round, warmer, darker quality that I feel like really works for his voice.
Just like the day that I met you, the day I thought forever, said that you love me, that will last forever. It's cold outside, like we don't work out my life. Why you work out my life? I get like this every time. All these days it feel like you and me. Heartbreak and a first for me.
I also like how when he goes up higher in his voice, the darkness goes away. Time. There's a little more smile, a little more spreadness right there. And you don't hear as much of that darker, tonguey quality that I was talking about earlier. When he's kind of low in his mid-low range, he kind of has that quality. But as he goes up, he really gets a little more brighter in terms of how he shapes his voice or his vocal tract. I'm sorry, how he shapes his vocal tract and how he shapes his articulation in this way. And I really admire that he really still plays with what he sounds like depending on where he is. And he really brightens up and he gives us a nice, like a low tenor-y quality, middle tenor-y quality a little bit when it goes up a little bit. But he still has that lower voice, lower larynx, the more open vocal tract element to his voice no matter where he goes. But you can still hear him narrowing the vocal tract a little bit and kind of raising the larynx up a little bit as he sings. You can hear those different timbres and those different textures come out in different parts of his voice, especially in his performance.
I still see the messages you read.
I also hear a lot of lax articulation. And I don't mean lax as in he's not doing a good job or that he's being lazy. It's just not super ultra enunciated. It's kind of more chill. And I always tell my clients, clear consonants over hard consonants. Forget trying to be all clear and precise and enunciate everything. That can get in the way of the vocal line sometimes and get in the way of the aesthetic of the song. And he really focuses on really kind of being more lax. And I feel like it works for his voice and who he is as an artist. You know, I really like the approach to his lax articulation that he really takes. You know, it's going to be right here. It's going to sit right here. We're not going to do a lot of this. You know, we're not going to do a lot of that. Everything's going to sit right here. He'll get brighter a little bit. He'll kind of smile a little bit more, get a little more spread and things like that. But generally, it's going to stay right here. And it's going to be almost a warm quality to his articulation, too. There's almost a warm, puckering quality to his articulation. So he doesn't do a lot of this. Everything kind of stays right here. You know, a little bit like that, you know?
I'm foolishly patient.
He really got a little more bright, a little more nasal. Love me. Any voice can get nasal at any given point, and nasality is not a bad thing. He got a little more bright on that me. And that's what I was referring to. Like, he really gets brighter and really plays with his timbre and placement and things like that, depending on where he is in his range, what he's trying to do, the emotion behind what he's saying here. He has versatility. He's clearly showing that right here. He's really showing a lot of timbres and textures and colors in this performance.
It's cold outside, like when you
videos about different artists, depending on who they are, I may do some more research, like, you know, watch interviews about them and things like that, just so I can speak from a more clear and definitive point of view about this artist. And I remember watching one of his interviews, and he said Frank Sinatra was a person that inspired him. You know, those of you who don't know Frank Sinatra, just look him up. He's a very well-known singer, very smooth voice. And I remember Frank Sinatra when I was little. I think he passed away when I was pretty young, but I remember seeing him when I was little, like on TV, things like that. When he said that he was inspired by Frank Sinatra, I said, ooh, that makes sense, because there is a smooth quality to his voice, and he really gravitated towards people that reflected his voice type and his vocal range and what he could sing. Frank Sinatra was kind of a baritone type of voice, if you will. And so GIVĒON attached himself to voices that spoke to him. I attached to voices like Karen Clark Sheard, Lettucey, but those singers speak to my voice type and how I like to sing. And so I'm not going to attach myself necessarily in terms of vocal identity to like a Barry White. For what? For what, you know? So I respect GIVĒON for saying people like Frank Sinatra and things like that, that he was inspired by people like that, because that kind of speaks to his voice type and his style too. He had a little switch. Every time. He kind of went into the head voice. You can literally hear the register shift happen right there. Every hearing him pick up his voice and kind of get more beefier, chestier, beltier in his approach, because a lot of times you don't hear many artists, especially like guys and things like that, kind of go here unless they have a higher voice. But I love how he still takes you to his range, and he still gets up there, gets beefy, and you can hear the brightness and the more stronger quality in his voice when he gets up there in parts like this. I really enjoy hearing him in elements like this. Enjoy this analysis. And if you did, click subscribe down below to click the alert button next week so you know when the next video is posted. And as I always say, be vocally bold, creative, and aware. But most of all, be vocally you. All right, y'all. I'll see y'all soon.